Bonjour à tous ou bonsoir, je ne sais pas où vous êtes et je ne sais pas quelle heure il est. So, today it's for beginners, so I will switch to English. I'm just always used to use French. So let's see who is here, and as usual, I will say hello to everybody before starting the lesson. So I have Hope is with us. Rita est là aussi. Luciana Moribé is with us too. Lisbeth nous dit bonjour. Ada est là aussi. Stardust is here. Fiona Adams is with us. Victoria Posse est là. Hilary Howell, bonjour. Vercingétorix, salut. Samantha Alonso est là aussi. Victoria Jacques. Yasmine. Sherilyn is here too. Olga Ruiz est avec nous. Bickert Cosmina Bellou est là. Ensuite, Mouskan aussi. Rupa est là. Varchar. And then Paul. Salut, Paul. Kirill est avec nous. So I guess we can start. Don't forget to... Attendez. Let me put it clearly now. Don't forget to... like. I mean, you know, this is the point. Let's try to hit the like button to make sure that we'll have the 100 as fast as possible, because this is the only thing I want you to give me in exchange for this lesson. Merci beaucoup. So I guess we can start the lesson. Before we start, two things. The first thing is that, as usual, I will repeat that, but still, remember to open a new tab, because it would be more efficient for you if you can, in the other tab, use or open a dictionary. So if you come up, or if you see new words in that case, you can have a look in the dictionary instead of asking me in the chat, because it will be more efficient that way. So we've been referencing all these things: wordreference.com, deeple.com, collingsdictionary.com, larousse.fr, and then Google Translate. So open that and then make a list of the new words that you will encounter today. So it would be extremely, extremely good for you. And then the other thing, remember, look, I've been putting a blinking arrow. So during this live, you can see that I've been doing some flashcards just for you. And so you will have more than 1,800 words, which are the most used words in the French language. So in blue, it's the nouns, so masculine and feminine, and in red, the verbs. Okay, so you can, during the lesson, have a look at these cards and try to see if you come up with new words, if you know them. If you don't know them, well, this is the way it should be. Seems like Vincent had the haircut. I'm shaving like that. Huh? This is the way it goes usually when I do it. Allez. And it's true that maybe I should do it like that, shaving, just to get more likes. Maybe this is the thing, because normally I don't really shave a lot. So let's start with the question of the day, la question du jour. And the question of the day is the following. It's the same, but it's okay. It's the same, I didn't change it. I think it was a different one. But, well, give me some advice. What could I do today? After the lesson, in the evening, give me a good advice. À votre avis, qu'est-ce que je devrais faire ce soir? Tout est possible. Merci. Allez-y. Alors, c'est My Stuff qui commence. My Stuff is the first one to tell me discothèque. Mais c'est pas possible, les discothèques, c'est fini. Les discothèques, c'est fermé. Ça n'est plus possible d'aller dans les discothèques. Evelina qui me dit boire du vin direct. Bourneville Lover, jouer à Fall Guys. Oui, ah, mais j'attends parce que. C'est toujours Nicolas. Nicolas is playing Fall Guys and I'm looking at him because it's for more fun. Luciana Moribé, si tu peux atteindre 100 likes avant de donner le cadeau. Ça va être difficile. Ça va être très difficile. Lisbeth, profitez de la journée. Très bien. Victoria Jacques, comment avons-nous boire du vin? Just to be honest, I've got some bubbles with me. So let's be clear, if the stream is cutting, it's because of the bubbles. J'ai des bulles. Fiona Adams, profitez en famille. Très bien. Hilary Howell, vous devriez sourire. Oh ben, je souris régulièrement. Ada, à mon avis, ce soir, vous devriez faire ce qui vous rend heureux. Très bien. Kirill, regardez un film comme Amélie. Amélie, c'est toujours sympathique. It's always nice to watch Amélie because you can always find some new details. Oui, merci. Iris, vous devriez faire une promenade dans le parc central ce soir, peut-être. Curiosidades touche... Oh, pardon. Oh, I lost you, Curiosidades. Where are you? Ah, oh, you're here. Toucher la langue avec le coude. C'est pas possible. C'est pas possible. It's not possible. Well, I will have to try after. Varsha, tonight you should try producing. No, Varsha, we don't write in English. We can't communicate like that, but you should write in French. This is the exercise, d'accord? Bickert, je devrais faire plus d'exercices de français ce soir. Très bien, ça c'est pour vous. Julia, regardez un film, par exemple, Le Bonheur des Uns. Il est pas mal, Le Bonheur des Uns. J'ai regardé hier Notre-Dame. So Notre-Dame, it's a French movie. It's really, really, really nice. It was produced like last year, I guess. And it's a really, I mean, it's a French movie. So nothing much happens, but it's really great. Notre-Dame, if you have the chance, watch this movie. It's really nice. Yasmine, je pense que tu devrais sortir pour une promenade du soir. Samantha, what do you think I should do tonight? Well... Ah, je ne sais pas. Stardust, tu pourrais faire quelque chose avec tes enfants, faire du patin à glace ou faire une belle promenade. Ouais. Mouskan, à mon avis, vous devriez vous relaxer un petit peu parce que, monsieur, vous travaillez plus dur. Oh, ça va, c'est pas... I'm not working in a factory, and let's not complain about that. Hein. Franchement, it could be worse. Cosmina Bello, à mon avis, vous devriez parler avec votre fille. Et jouer avec votre fils. Après, vous devriez préparer le dîner et regarder un bon film. Oui, bah, c'est un petit peu ma routine. Sundar, jouer avec Nicolas. Oui. Ensuite, Olga, écrire une histoire drôle pour nous. Une histoire drôle, ça, c'est intéressant. Rajani, faire une pizza et des cocktails. Oui, pourquoi pas. Adi, je devrais faire à dîner. Oui, ça c'est une bonne idée. Vercingétorix, écouter une chanson de Charles Aznavour. J'aime beaucoup Charles Aznavour. Il y a beaucoup de chansons de Charles Aznavour qui sont vraiment, vraiment sympathiques. Quand vous cuisinez, Charles Aznavour, formidable. Cheryline, vous devriez porter un béret. Manger une baguette, boire du vin et prendre des photos pour nous montrer. Alors, je n'ai pas de béret. Peut-être que je devrais acheter un béret. Ah, la baguette, c'est normal. Allez, merci beaucoup. Attendez, je regarde. Ah, Ice Cubes qui nous rejoint, c'est gentil. Et Xuan qui dit, à mon avis, vous devriez vous relaxer, manger, regarder la télévision et jouer avant de dormir. Merci. Allez, on attaque avec la dictée. So we'll start with the dictation. It's not really common, but still I think that in most of the cases we tend to forget it because I've been putting that not really at the end, but so let's start with the dictation, if that's okay with you. So you know the way it works, I hope. So I will read four sentences. They are extremely simple, these ones, because it's the beginner level, so I didn't want to be tricky. So I read them, you write them, of course, because it's the beginner level, I give the translation, the English translation. So it's up to you whether you look at it or not. D'accord? So, but be aware that when I will click, you will have the translation. So try not to look at it if you don't want to look at it. So I will read the sentences two times. J'espère que vous êtes prêts. I hope you're ready because we're starting, right now. Allez, this is the first one, and the first one is the following. Elle mange toute seule. Elle mange toute seule. Écrivez la phrase, s'il vous plaît. Alors, let's look at your sentences. I mean, so far, so good. Vercingétorix, be careful. So let's have a look at the sentence. So normally you should have it on your screen. As you can see, well, the verb is manger. Manger is not really tricky. First group, so basically when you put that in the third person, you will end up with the as the ending. Okay, so mange, M-A-N-G-E. D'accord? Donc, elle mange. After that, because we are here, having a feminine, we should definitely put first toute in the feminine form, so T-O-U-T-E, and then seul in the feminine form to S-E-U-L-E. D'accord? Elle mange toute seule. D'accord? Alors, très bien, ben on continue. Let's continue with the next one. Numéro 2, attention, attention. Elle ne veut pas y croire. Elle ne veut pas y croire. Bonsoir Daria. Bonsoir, bonsoir. On fait la dictée. Allez, write the sentence, please. Alors, je regarde, Cosmina Bellou commence, Ada aussi, ok, donc so far so good, hein? Pas mal du tout, pas mal du tout, so let's have a look at the sentence, oops, sorry, it was, I've been forgetting to click on the thing, so this is the sentence, so the verb is vouloir, remember, vouloir is somehow tricky when you conjugate it, because veut will be the first form, V-E-U-X, don't pronounce the final X, tu veux, V-E-U-X, same thing, il, elle, veut, because this is the form that we have, V-E-U-T, you don't pronounce it, but still it should be there, so elle veut, then after that, of course I wanted to put the negative form, so elle ne veut pas. D'accord? And of course, let's try to squeeze a little pronoun. The pronoun would be Y, donc I. Elle ne veut pas I. And then your verb croire should be definitely in the infinitive form. So remember, the verb croire, to believe, is written C-R-O-I-R-E. D'accord, so you've got in the end of croire. Well, it seems that most of you actually had the proper form, so félicitations. Numéro 3, same thing here, remember, I will give the translation, don't look at it if you don't want to, be helped too much. Alors, let me try to scroll to see. Voilà. Oh, ça c'est romantique. Elle le regarde tendrement. Elle le regarde tendrement. So write the sentence, s'il vous plaît. Alors, let's have a look at your sentences because you, it looks really good. It looks really good. So in that case, let's agree on the fact that the verb is regarder. Regular verb from the first group, so it's not really tricky. You conjugate it in the third person, so elle regarde e. D'accord? Of course, I wanted to introduce a pronoun, as I usually do. So this pronoun is pronom complément d'objet direct. Remember, pronom complément d'objet direct will always be before the verb. D'accord? So it means that le will be before your verb. Elle, le, regarde. And then after that, I wanted to put an adverb. This is what we call adverbe de manière. Well, all these adverbs that will end with ment, remember? But the concept, the basic concept, of course, we've got some exceptions, but the basic concept of these adverbs, it's just that you will put it after the verb. Adverb, hein? So you add this thing to the verb. So it means that it should come definitely after your verb. Tendrement. Remember, the way to construct these adverbs, it's based on the adjective. So, basic adjective, masculine adjective will be tendre. Then only after that, you need to go through the feminine form, which is the same in that case, tendre. And after that, you will add M-E-N-T, ment, and you get your adverb. Tendre, masculine form, tendre. Feminine form for the adjectives, tendrement, the adverb. This is the way to construct them. Allez, on continue. Numéro 4. Numéro 4, same thing here. Don't look at the translation. If you don't want to be helped, bonjour, tool, you can participate. This is the dictation. Ouria is joining us too. Bonjour, Ouria. I hope you're fine. Let's go for the sentence. Elle ne va pas y participer. Elle ne va pas y participer. Allez-y, écrivez la phrase, write the sentence, s'il vous plaît. Merci. Alors, je regarde vos phrases, but then at the same time, I was trying to do the Curiosidades challenge. I can't make it. It's not possible. Hein? La langue avec le coude, ça n'est pas possible. Si c'est possible, montrez-le-moi. Show it to me if you can do it. Alors, let's have a look at the sentence in that case. So, first verb in that case, it's aller. Aller should be, of course, conjugated according to the subject. The subject is elle. Third person of the singular, elle va. Remember the verb aller, it's a tricky one. Hein? Je vais, V-A-I-S, tu vas, V-A-S, il, elle va, V-A. D'accord? After that, of course, I wanted to put the negative form, so before and after your conjugated verb. Elle ne va pas. D'accord? Then, of course, I wanted to squeeze, as usual, a pronoun just for you to get used how to put the pronoun. And the pronoun I is clearly connected to the verb participer. So this is the reason why it should be before the verb. I, and after that you put the infinitive, participer, infinitive, because it's the second verb. Okay? Merci beaucoup. Félicitations pour tout le monde. Let's have a look at the next exercise. The next exercise is how can you translate? And in that case, I wanted, so I've been doing two for this lesson. We'll see if we have the time to do them. We'll see. So it's only verbs. Verbs, and I took my list of the most used verbs in the French language. They can be a bit tricky, these ones. I mean, we'll try to see together. The only thing is, look at that. So I will give you first, of course, as usual, the translation, the English translation. So you can see that in that case, it's to abolish, to do away with. And I give you the two first letters. Okay, so try to give me the French version of, well, I mean, to abolish, to do away with. Allez-y, merci. Alors, effectivement, so far so good. Hein? Remember that the verb is abolir. Abolir belongs to the second group. J'abolis, tu abolis, il abolit. Nous abolissons, vous abolissez, ils abolissent. Okay, so it's a IR verb, IR, abolir, but it's not a tricky one, so it belongs to the second group. Okay, so let's have a look at the second one. And the second one is the translation of to absorb, to remove, to take up, to take. Et ça commence, and it starts with A, B. Try to see how to translate that into French. Merci. Et c'est Vercingétorix, hein, le roi des Francs, qui nous donne la première réponse. Et je dis bravo, bravo, bravo. Victoria Posse qui dit l'écran est mort. Ce n'est pas moi, ce n'est pas moi, Victoria Posse. It's not me. So of course, in that case, we're asking for, or we're looking for the verb absorber. Absorber. So remember that it's a first group verb. So it's not really tricky to conjugate. J'absorbe, tu absorbes, il absorbe, elle absorbe, nous absorbons, vous absorbez, ils absorbent, elles absorbent. Très bien. Bah oui, Vercingétorix, youpi, 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 le roi des Francs. The first king that we had in France is Vercingétorix. So even if we lost against Julius César, still he's the first king. Allez, numéro 3, and say to abstain or to refrain. And the, well, I mean the verb should start with AB. Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. You are right. I'm sorry about that. Let's have a look at the thing. So I've been refreshing the chat. If that was the chat, then in that case, it should be working now, at least I hope. So to abstain or to refrain is, in fact, not really tricky. It's abstenir. Be careful with abstenir, because abstenir, it's like tenir. So even if it ends with er, in fact, it's a bit tricky because it belongs to the third group. So it will be conjugated like tenir. Remember, tenir, je tiens, tu tiens, il, elle tient. D'accord? Nous tenons, vous tenez, il, elle tiennent. So be careful. So obviously, abstenir will be j'abstiens, tu abstiens, il abstient, nous abstenons, vous abstenez, ils abstiennent. But in most of the cases, it's true. Somebody was offering the thing with the reflexive form. So s'abstenir would be also the best way maybe to use it. Je m'abstiens, tu t'abstiens, il, elle s'abstient, nous nous abstenons, vous vous abstenez, il, elle s'abstiennent. D'accord? Allez, on continue avec numéro 4. Numéro 4, nous y allons. Et numéro 4, eh bien, c'est to abuse, mislead or take advantage. And it starts with AB2. Allez-y. Effectivement, so as you can see, in fact, in that case, it's not really tricky because if you think about that, they're so close. So to abuse will be abuser. I'm pretty sure that if we're talking about, Victoria Posse would probably confirm the fact that probably in Spanish it's the same. Ice Cubes could say that maybe in Italian it's the same. We share, and it's coming from Latin, so it's the It's the responsibility of Ice Cubes in that case. So, abuser, regular verb from the first group, extremely, extremely simple to conjugate. J'abuse, tu abuses, il abuse, nous abusons, vous abusez, ils abusent. D'accord? So, it's not really tricky, this one. So, let's have a look at numéro 5. Numéro 5, same thing here. Of course, it will be simple, but still, show me that you know it. To accept, how is it in French? And of course, it starts with AC. Allez-y, s'il vous plaît. Alors, I can see that Julia decided to somehow change the French language because this verb accepter, which belongs to the first group, Julia decided to create this acceptir, which sounds quite nice, acceptir, but it doesn't yet exist. So accepter is from the first group, simple to conjugate as usual. J'accepte, tu acceptes, il, elle accepte, nous acceptons, vous acceptez, il, elle accepte. Souvenez-vous, remember, E-N-T in the end. Eka is joining us. Bonjour, bonjour, Eka. You can participate. We are looking at verbs, d'accord? So let's start with the, let's continue, sorry, with the numéro 6. Numéro 6. So be careful. We had to accept, but I want another one in that case, and it's to accept or to approve of. And this one starts with AG. It's a bit tricky. I am not really sure if you know it, but try your best. AG, let's go for it. I can see that I'm reaching the your limits. Oh, Evelina, félicitations. Evelina, she's the princess or the queen of the exercise because Evelina has been giving this agréé verb. Yeah, we don't really use it a lot. I mean, in most of the cases, when you start to write a formal letter, in the end, normally, instead of accepter, you use agréé. Je vous souhaite d'agréer, etc. So this is another verb. So maybe if you encounter it, I mean, you know that basically it means to accept, but it's another way. So it's a synonym in a way. Agréer. Remember first group. So it means that it's not really tricky to conjugate. Hein? J'agrée, tu agrées, il agrée, nous agréons, vous agréez. Ils agréent. Félicitations, Evelina. Yeah, you can be proud of yourself because you made it. Félicitations. Numéro 7. Let's have a look at numéro 7. To access, to reach, to attain. And of course, it starts with AC. It should be extremely simple. Alors, Iris is leaving us. Au revoir, Iris. See you soon. À bientôt. Shashank is joining us. Hi, you were there yesterday. Don't spam. So, of course, this one is accéder. So, you have it. So, basically, it's quite simple in that case. You know that it belongs to the first group. Be careful, Romand. It's not access. Hein? It's really the verb. Hein? The verb is accéder, hein, accéder. So in that case, you will write it like that. A-C-C-E, accent aigu, D-E-R. D'accord? Allez, let's have a look at numéro 8. Numéro 8, it's the translation of to accompany. So how does it show in French? And remember that it will start with A-C. Allez-y. Thank you. Alors, so far so good. Attention, Ice Cube. Hein. Don't start to mistreat the French language. Maybe in Italian you don't have the G, but we have this beautiful G in French. So remember to write it with G. Accompagné. Phonetically, you wrote it extremely good, Ice Cubes, but remember this nye nye sound in French, in most of the cases, it will be GN. Nye nye nye. Remember. Accompagné. After that, for the conjugation, it's not really tricky. Hein. J'accompagne, tu accompagnes, il, elle accompagne, nous accompagnons, vous accompagnez, ils accompagnent. I can see that everyone agrees on that. Noura, it was a bit ole ole because you've been adding this E to your thing. But for the others, no, it's good. Don't forget the M after the O, accompagné, because you've got P after. So let's have a look at numéro 9. Numéro 9, it will be simple. It will be simple. To accomplish, how would you say to accomplish in French? Thinking that maybe it will be close, so try to see it. Alors, I can see that you are giving me, in fact, the proper translation. So it's accomplir, d'accord? Accomplir, remember, from the second group. So in that case, Julia agrees. She doesn't want to switch that to the first group. I mean, we don't know. Sometimes she switches from the first to the second, and now it could be from the second to the first, but now it was good. So if it's still, I will have to check for the freezing thing. So to accomplish is accomplir. Remember, accomplir when you conjugate it, because it's from the second group, so it will be j'accomplis, IS. Tu accomplis, IS. Il, elle accomplit, IT. Nous accomplissons, vous accomplissez, ils, elles accomplissent. Allez, let's have a look at the last one, and after that I will, on my own, have a look at the chat thing, because the chat, well, I don't really know what's happening. I have some problem, technical problems, as we usually do. To accumulate, to amass, to store, or to stockpile. Let's have a look at that and give me, please, the translation. Alors, let's have a look at your things. And so far, it's good. So I've been restoring the thing. My mom usually told me, never multitask. You are a man. I guess she was right. But still, I have to multitask with these streams. Merci beaucoup, Rita. Rita is once again sponsoring my coffee, and it's nice. Merci beaucoup. So in that case, to accumulate, to amass, to store, to stockpile is, of course, accumuler. Accumuler, remember that it's not really tricky to conjugate. It will be from the first group. So j'accumule, tu accumules, il, elle accumule, nous accumulons, vous accumulez, ils, elles accumulent. You make the liaison because it sounds nicer. Merci beaucoup. It's an interesting live this time. Hein? Many things are happening. Allez. Alors, let's continue with what do they think. It was interesting because today I came across this website that has some really nice pictures. So I wanted to include the pictures or the drawings in this live. So basically, the exercise is what do they think? Spiritual Weapons, bonjour, bonjour. Yeah, please click on the like. It seems that it will be impossible to reach the 100 today. Let's be honest with that, but it's okay. Let's do the best that we can. Viva, you need to click on like, please. And hi, hello. Please join the lesson. So what do they think? And look, the way will be extremely simple. The way to do will be simple. You will have to translate. So basically, I will give you, as you can see now, a little picture. And I think it's really nicely drawn. You've got the translation. The English translation, we share this file. How could you translate that into French? So write the sentence. So in that case, it's, I mean, short sentences, but still you should write the sentences in French and let's see if it's correct. D'accord? Merci beaucoup. Allez-y. Alors, je peux voir que Yesero is the first one to give the translation. So it's good, Yesero, in fact, because you went for the N. So of course, I want to work a bit on the conjugation. So even if we agree that in most of the cases, when we speak, if it's not really, formal, if it's informal, we won't use nous, we will use on. But let's agree on that. Normally, it should be nous. And in some certain situations, if it's formal, you will use new. So it's always better to start with the formal thing and after that take some liberty with the language. D'accord? So in that situation, we will use the nous. Nous partageons, especially because remember that partager is a tricky verb when it comes to the new form. You need to keep the Nous partageons, remember after, dossier is a masculine noun. So it means that your definite adjective, ce, should be the masculine form, ce dossier. Nous partageons ce dossier. Hein? I really wanted to use the ce in that case. D'accord? So let's have a look at the numéro 2. And numéro 2 is we like to work together. We like to work together. I think the drawing is really nice. It's really well done. So can you translate this sentence into French? Merci beaucoup. My Life is joining us. Bonjour, Hola My Life. Hey, don't forget to click on like. This is the only thing I'm asking you to do before joining the lesson. You know how it goes. You know the rules. So we like to work together. Well, the structure is not really tricky. Nous aimons, so you will conjugate the verb aimer for the new form. Nous aimons, remember, it's the present tense. After that, the second verb travailler should be definitely in the infinitive. Nous aimons travailler. And then ensemble, nous aimons travailler ensemble. So far, well, I can see few little mistakes, but then Ada has been correcting because, of course, you were putting nous aimerons. I saw Ada. Ada, you've been putting the future, but then you were smart enough to correct yourself. Bravo, bravo, Ada. Cosmina Bellou, c'est bien. Oui. No, no, it's good. It is really, really, really good. So let's have a look at numéro 3. Numéro 3, I love fall. So fall, we're talking about the season, obviously. I love fall. Simple, short sentence. How could you translate that into French? Alors, it seems that Vercingétorix is a bit like Julia, totally destructuring the language. L'auton, it doesn't exist, Vercingétorix. No, no, no. Let's have a look at the way to write it. Phonetically, it was close somehow, but then it should be written l'automne, hein, Vercingétorix. Respect our language. L'automne, remember to write it. A-U-T-O-M-N-E. So it's really funny because this M, in fact, doesn't really exist at all phonetically. Hein? So you will pronounce it l'automne, na-na-na, but then you need to write the M because this is the way it should be written. Oui, bah oui, oui, Vercingétorix. Ouh là là, effectivement. Numéro 4, let's have a look at numéro 4. Fino Captain is joining us. Hi, please click on the like. Remember, this is the entry pass for the lessons. So let's try to translate that. I am, oops, sorry, I've been putting that two times. So, well, the thing is, I am the strongest. So, of course, in that case, it's quite interesting because I would like you to use this, well, this interesting form, the strongest. Let's have a look how you could translate the strongest in French. Allez-y. Mais que se passe-t-il? Evenina, you were the princess or the queen of the exercise and you've got to go. Au revoir. Have a good conference. Don't forget to not fall asleep if it's a bit boring. But it's possible that it's extremely, extremely interesting. Merci. Alors, regardons ensemble, voilà. Ok, je mets la traduction. So I'm putting the translation. So in that case, keep in mind that, because in that situation, well, you look, and this is the good thing about the pictures, you can see that we're talking about two men. And so, in fact, because we want to put in that case, le plus. And then everything should be in the masculine because the person who is talking is the person who is about to put the ball in the basket. So, je suis le plus fort. Everything should be in the masculine form. Le plus fort, d'accord? This is the superlative. Superlative will be according to the gender. If it's the feminine form, but in that case, it should be a woman. So, la plus forte. But now, it's only the masculine form. So, je suis le plus fort. D'accord? So, this is the way it goes. Let's have a look at numéro 5. Numéro 5, and it's I like to have a drink with my colleague. I have to have a drink with my colleague. How could you translate that into French? Allez-y. Alors, in that case, it's ice cubes. Ice cubes were the first one, but then, of course, in that case, it is somehow cultural. Because a drink in some cultures would be un verre. In other cultures, in other countries, it can be un café. But then a drink, in most of the cases, if we're talking about French culture, you will translate that by, it's not really un café, because un café would say a coffee, hein, un café, but then it's un verre. To have a drink, it's avoir un verre, prendre un verre, d'accord? It's like a glass, hein? Prendre un verre avec ma collègue. In that case, I wanted to put the picture just to make it clear that my colleague, in that case, we're talking about the feminine form, so it's ma collègue. Hein? Remember that it's not the plural form like Julia has been generously giving us. It's not the plural form, it's only one person, and it's a woman, so it's ma collègue, d'accord? J'aime prendre un verre avec ma collègue. Allez, let's have a look at the next one. Numéro 6. Numéro 6, attention. I love reading. It's extremely short. It shouldn't be so difficult to translate. Allez-y. Alors, let's have a look at what you give me. So, there are two options. Hein? I went for the substantive. You, in most of the cases, you go through the verb and it's totally good. So, you can say, j'adore lire. D'accord? You could go for, j'aime lire. I would accept that. J'aime, j'adore. And then the verb, lire, infinitive, it's okay. Now, two options if you want to go like I did with the substantive, the noun, because I wanted, of course, to go through the difficult way. J'adore, or then you can go with j'aime, and remember that it's, in that case, la lecture. This is just to for you to remember that une lecture, la lecture, it's the action of reading. So we're not talking, because it's a common mistake for certain persons to think that it's a lecture, like something, a lesson that can happen in the university, at the university. No, no, no. La lecture, it's really the action of reading, d'accord? So whether j'adore, j'aime lire, which I agree it's good, or then J'adore la lecture. J'aime la lecture. Sunday is asking, when should we use aimer and adorer? It's up to you, Sundar. It's a question of intensity. So basically, to make it simple, to make it short. But after that, you know how it goes. There are some differences. But let's try to make it simple. J'aime bien. So when you use aimer, and after that you put the adverb bien. J'aime bien will be I like. D'accord? J'aime, it's I love. With variation of intensity, but it's I love. D'accord? J'adore, it's I adore or I love. I love a lot. D'accord? So the difference between I love and I adore, it's not really clear. It's not really clear, so it's up to you to define whether it's extremely intense. If it's extremely intense, it's j'adore. If you love something, it's j'aime. D'accord? So after that, if it's I like, j'aime bien. Bien, bien, bien is the important thing. So you put the adverb to reduce the intensity of aimer. This is the point. Let's have a look at numéro 7. Numéro 7 is I have to work at home. I have to work at home like a lot of us. Allez-y. Eh bien voilà, je retrouve les qualités de notre roi de Vercingétorix. J'ai oui le roi des Francs qui nous donne la bonne traduction. Bravo Vercingétorix. In that case, we want to use the verb devoir. So remember, the verb devoir is quite interesting because it's to have to concept, but then we can conjugate it with other persons. Remember that falloir, it's a tricky one because it's impersonal. So now it would be more simple, in fact, like you did. You go with devoir. Remember devoir, a bit tricky when you conjugate that for the first person. So je dois, D-O-I-S. Tu dois, D-O-I-S. Il, elle doit, D-O-I-T. Phonetically, it's the same, but then remember to write it differently. So in that situation, je dois. Second verb, obviously, infinitive, travailler. And then at home, remember in French, à la maison. Je dois travailler à la maison. Allez, let's go, numéro 8. We need to find a solution. We need to find a solution. How could you translate that into French? Que se passe-t-il? Hero King is late. Vous êtes en retard. Click on like, remember. Let's try to have 100, but I think it won't be possible. It won't be possible. I will cry. Click on like if you didn't yet. Click on like because people are coming and going. So if people didn't click on like yet, be nice with me. It would please me so much to have at least 100, even if I know that it will be difficult today. But anyways, so let's see. We need to find a solution. So the verb is devoir. D'accord? So we conjugate devoir in the first person of the plural. Nous devons. D'accord? Second verb should be definitely in the infinitive form. Trouver. Nous devons trouver. And after that, it's not really difficult because it's solution. Solution is a feminine noun, so une solution. Nous devons trouver une solution. Julia went for il nous faut trouver la solution. C'est magnifique. C'est magnifique. It's totally correct. If you want to go for the impersonal form and then squeeze the nous, it's extremely good. Il nous faut trouver. It is perfect. It is perfect. Très bien. Let's have a look at the next one. And the next one, numéro 9. Numéro 9. It's weird. The boss doesn't arrive. Allez-y. Alors, let me have a look at what you're writing. Eh oui, Cosmina Bellou, c'est Zarbi. I ought to squeeze your language from the street. D'accord. You know what? I went to Paris 8. Hein, Paris 8, when I was a student, it was in Saint-Denis. So we were in the Wesh-Wesh area. So, c'est bizarre, le bus n'arrive pas. Très bien, donc c'est bizarre, c'est étrange. I don't know, in most of the cases you went for c'est bizarre. And it's good because we use it quite a lot. Julia went for the boss. It's not le boss. Hein? Non, c'est le bus. Nous sommes d'accord, le bus. And after that you went for the arrivé, regular verb. You put the negative form, n'arrive pas. C'est bizarre, le bus n'arrive pas. It's always stressful when the bus doesn't arrive. I mean, we know that. We know that. Numéro 10, allez, it's the last one. I am proud of my car. Look at the character, because the character, it's a man. So, of course, it will somehow define the way you will structure your sentence. Hein? I am proud of my car. Alors, yeah, I'm rocking it. Moi aussi, j'étais à Paris 8, oui, mais moi, j'étais à Paris 8 à l'époque de NTM, de MC Solar, monsieur. C'était la période du Wesh Wesh. Alors, nous continuons avec I am proud of my car. So, we agree that in that case, the adjective is fier. So, it's a tricky one because fier, as you probably remember, and I don't know if you do, but then if you do, then fier is phonetically exactly the same if it's the masculine or the feminine. But in that situation, because the character, as you can see in the picture, is a man, so you should write it F-I-E-R. D'accord? Because I can see that Ada has been putting the feminine form, Of course, phonetically, it's good. It is really good because fier would be exactly the same. If it's a woman, then in that case, it would be je suis fier with the feminine form. But here, it's a man, so it should be written F-I-E-R. Être fier de. Remember, you will structure it with the preposition de. And after that, ma. Voiture. Très bien. Ada, j'adore MC Solar. Yeah, well, we need to discuss about the different periods of MC Solar because I was there at the beginning and trust me, it was different. It was different, but I mean, you know how it goes. I mean, when we're getting old, I mean, we regret the past tense and it was better in the beginning. Allez, on y va! Alors, one little second, because I want to be professional, and then Luciana is asking, could we use avoir besoin in the last thing instead of devoir? So, I have to work at home. J'ai besoin de travailler à la maison. Yeah. There is, if we really want to go into the details, Luciana, there is a slight difference between avoir besoin de, so this need, and this have to. So after that, whether you feel the difference between the two or not, but there is a slight difference. So I need, it's something that you decide. I have to, it's in fact something that you don't really decide. So it's extremely thin. So basically, my answer to you, Luciana, if you really want to use, well, j'ai besoin de instead of devoir, I mean, in the end, it won't make a big difference. But if you really want to be a purist, there is a slight difference between the two. Allez. So as you know, you don't start, please, don't start right now. Just wait for the music because I will have to press on something here and I will try to make it proper. Yes. So the way it will go, yeah, it's the time to win the little gift. Yuppie, yuppie. So let's have a look. Only persons who didn't yet win anything can participate because I think it's only fair. So if you already won something, then please don't click, don't do anything. So the concept is extremely simple, d'accord? You will just pick one number from 1 to 20, and I will pick one, and you will have to try to find the number that I put. Let's... Oh, that's it. I've been writing that on my notepad. I don't show you because it's on the other side. So you try to find this number. Be nice and only write one thing. D'accord? Only one number, it would be nice. So try to guess the number that I've been finding or writing. And after that, I will give you the access to the platform frenchwithvincent.com. D'accord? So it's quite simple. Let's make it fast. And after that, we'll have the time to continue the lesson because this is the idea. The idea is to learn things together. So you can try, I mean, to find the number right now. You can start. Alors, attendez, j'ai beaucoup de boutons, il faut que j'appuie sur beaucoup de boutons et c'est toujours très très complexe. Est-ce que Kirill est avec nous? Kirill, attendez, voilà, Kirill, est-ce que vous êtes là? Vous avez, so you've been putting the proper number and it was two, merci beaucoup. Kirill, so let's congratulate Kirill because Kirill just won the access, bravo Kirill. Kirill, bravo, bravo, je suis très content pour vous, I'm so happy for you, so basically the way it will go, and you will see that it's extremely simple, you just need to register to the platform frenchwithvincent.com, then you send me an email, and you say that this is me, Kirill, so this is my login, or the name that you've been putting on the platform. Please, I've been winning the thing. I will give you the access and of course, but you will have to learn a lot. You will have to learn a lot. I've been putting so many videos there. I mean, you can really master French. It's just in that case, your decision to make sure that you can, I mean, you can master French because clearly you can reach, I mean, the level C1, I mean, clearly C1 with only the videos I've been putting. I mean, I will explain you everything. Merci beaucoup, Kirill. Hey, félicitations. I'm so happy for you. Félicitations once again. So it took a long time to arrive this word of the day, but then, well, sometimes that's the way it goes. Let's have a... Well, once again, I'm struggling with the thing. Pow! That's it. So could you give me, please, the word that could sum up your day? Quel mot pourrait résumer votre journée aujourd'hui? Remember that the concept is just to put one word. Please don't put a sentence, just put one word. It would be so nice. Allez-y, merci beaucoup. Alors attention, Bourville Lover nous dit super, Cosmina Bellou, peinard, Vercingétorix, brise, la brise, Chauchin qui nous dit fromage, très bien, j'adore le fromage. Alors j'adore le fromage, je ne sais pas si vous c'est pareil, mais alors... Bon, well, it's because I'm French, probably. Ada qui nous dit l'hibernation. On reste dans la cave. Fiona Adams pense aussi à toi, Vincent. On a reçu 102 likes. Ouais, merci beaucoup. Cheryline, souris. Waouh, ça c'est intéressant comme mot. Rita, yes you can. D'accord. Ah, d'accord, c'est parfait. Daria, Daria, bah, tout le monde discute, tout le monde discute. Quelqu'un a mis jardinage. Qui est-ce que c'était? Qui avait mis jardinage? Irocking, jardinage. Ça, c'est sympa le jardinage, c'est vraiment bien. Hilary Howell, agréable. Stardust, bonheur. Mais c'est magnifique, tout le monde est joyeux ici. Fino qui nous dit super. Eh bien, ça, c'est bien. Victoria Jacques, somnolent. Mais c'est le matin. Est-ce que, qu'est-ce qui se passe, Victoria Jacques? Vous avez, moi, j'ai un problème, je suis déconnecté avec le rythme pour dormir. C'est ça aussi. Il faut trouver une façon de vous réadapter au rythme du sommeil. Yesero, l'espoir. Yasmine, youpi! Yulia, marcher. C'est possible de marcher, ça dépend des endroits, hein. Il y a des endroits où on doit rester dans un périmètre de 1 km. MNM19, fièvre. Oh! Faites attention à MNM19. J'espère que c'est la...